Titan. It is a mystery of the solar system. The surface of rivers, lakes, and oceans contain stable liquids. Like Earth, all life is sustained by a vast hydrological system of evaporation and precipitation, one of which you are currently standing on. Surface water is unique to this planet. In the world of Titan, however, liquid hydrocarbons instead of water make up the oceans. It was a world with orange skies containing bright methane clouds and ethane waters with small waves. On a bizarre anti-Earth, hydrocarbon dunes loom over icy, frozen shores. There are no planets on this planet. Instead, it is a moon. Titan is the largest satellite of the Saturn gas giant. Humanity has never discovered anything comparable. As we investigate a moon that is more complex and intriguing than most planets, we will embark on a perilous journey to the outer solar system. The gas giants in solar system models never depict the two moons in the solar system that are larger than Mercury. Ganymede is Jupiter's moon, and then Titan, with a diameter of 5,149.5 kilometers or 3,200 miles. The largest moon of Saturn dominates its innermost planet due to its size. It is marginally more expansive than Ganymede. Ganymede is one of four enormous moons that orbit Jupiter, sharing the limelight with Io, Callisto, and Europa. Titan, in contrast, is distinguished by magnificent isolation. Saturn has at least 80 moons, but this is one of the most prominent. Titan moons are uncommonly small, hence their moniker. After the Greek mythology Titans, a deity named Zeus cast the pre-Olympian giants into Hades. However, as the saying goes, size isn't everything, and Titan has more to offer than just its immense dimensions. It orbits Saturn at 1.2 million kilometers, and light takes 80 minutes to reach it from the Sun. Even on the cloudiest day, sunlight is approximately 100 times fainter in the outer solar system than in Seattle. Titan, like Saturn, encounters seasons due to its inclination. On Titan, summer lasts for 12 months instead of 3. Therefore, Titan's year is approximately 30 years long. When Saturn and Titan complete one orbit around our star, every experience you have ever had will have occurred. To avoid upsetting the space nerds, these are the bare facts we must address. We become fascinated when we focus on and investigate this world in minute detail. As we descend towards the surface, we will observe that we cannot see it. Titan is the only moon in our solar system with a substantial atmosphere, as a bubble of golden cloud completely encircles it. Titan's atmosphere is primarily composed of nitrogen, unlike Earth's, but it lacks the oxygen necessary for life. Methane, in contrast, rates second. There can be no process that leaves behind these gases. During Titan's formation, the Sun's energy should have transformed the methane in Titan's atmosphere to other hydrocarbons. On the Moon, there must be a perpetual replenishment mechanism. The greenhouse effect is another similarity between this atmosphere and our own. Titan's surface warms up because of the trapped methane radiation. However, the effects are reversible. As a result of Titan's highly reflective atmosphere, very little sunlight ever reaches the planet's surface, reducing the temperature. Titan's surface would be slightly warmer if it had no atmosphere, around 21 degrees Celsius more. However, these few degrees do not make much difference because it is already so frigid that even Canadians consider it chilly. One can experience Siberia in hell by standing on Titan. Temperatures are bone-chilling at minus 179 degrees Celsius. At these temperatures, water becomes as solid as granite. In fact, it is believed that the majority of Titan's surface consists of solid ice that has formed mountains, balls, and canyons. However, this does not mean that there is no liquid. As the Whistler probe traverses Titan's hazy atmosphere, we may have the good fortune to pass by the clouds. On this moon, clouds frequently indicate something not found anywhere else in the solar system: direct precipitation from Earth. The north polar region of Titan is nearby. Kraken Mare is one of the greatest tourist attractions in the solar system, one of the world's greatest oceans. With a surface area of 500,000 square kilometers and depths of at least 300 meters, the Kraken Mare is larger than the Great Lakes combined. 80% of the liquid on Titan is contained within it. Nonetheless, this is not an isolated occurrence. An excellent sea mare called Ligeia Mare rests nearby. This is one of the scores of bodies of water strewn across Titan's northern and southern regions. On the moon, there is no static separation between these seasons. The icy plains are traversed by large rivers with rapids and waterfalls. All of these are sustained by a hydrological cycle which sees evaporation from clouds and rain returning to the surface, producing streams and creeks that erode and carve through the ground like our water cycle. This is a unique aspect of the solar system. Despite evidence that Mars once had rivers, deltas, and similar features, they have all vanished over time. On Titan, liquids are currently circulating. Nevertheless, as stated in the introduction, there are rivers in which swimming is acceptable. Methane and ethane are the gases found in Titan's rivers and oceans. Liquid propellant deltas. Lakes are nourished by dunes of dark hydrocarbons shaped by howling nitrogen winds. During this peculiar cycle, even the rain behaves differently. It takes 9.2 seconds for a raindrop to descend on Earth. Slow-moving raindrops descend 6 times slower on Titan than Earth, due to the planet's lower gravity. The planet's thin atmosphere and feeble ice gravity prevent us from fitting anywhere else. Titan is the best location in the universe to fly. Stand on the surface while flapping your arms while donning artificial wings. You will feel like an ungainly albatross as you fly. However, let's return to the liquids. On this distant planet, flux is not limited to hydrocarbons. Cryovolcanism may exist as well. Essentially, a cryovolcano is a volcano that discharges liquid water rather than magma. Titan's surface is mind-numbingly frigid, so even super cold water seeps across the landscape, destroying everything before solidifying. At this time, it is only theorized that Titan has such cryovolcanism. This is how mountain ranges are believed to have formed, but evidence is required. There is no doubt, however, that additional substances exist beneath the surface, including water this time. The internal structure of Titan resembles an onion. There are multiple facets to it. Ice 6 is a high-pressure stratum of water ice at the center of a vast silicate rock core. Next, Titan's potential is demonstrated in detail. The surface of Titan is encircled by a saline ammonia-infused ocean that is kept at low temperatures. Few objects on Earth are more valuable than water. This is why NASA sent the Perseverance rover to a dry riverbed on Mars. This is a persuasive argument for why the Europa Clipper in 2030 will be a game-changing event. An examination of water plumes on the moon of Jupiter. We may discover our first extraterrestrial microorganisms if we detect traces of H2O. However, Titan may be even more intriguing. Astrobiologists are interested in the subsurface ocean and hydrocarbon seas, prebiotic atmospheres, organic compounds, and irregular water cycles. In addition, Titan's frozen surface may have supported life. It would be unlike anything we can fathom if it had. As specialists frequently point out, a habitable location need not be occupied. Despite containing all of the necessary ingredients for life, Titan's interior may remain lifeless. That is now out of the way. Titan could support either Earth-like or exceedingly alien life forms. If it resembles Earth, it is alive in the ocean's depths. This will have a profound effect. The ocean of Titan is likely frigid and pitch black, perhaps as low as minus 97 degrees Celsius. Ammonia keeps it liquid. Due to the intense pressure, it is impossible to find dolphins from another planet. If life exists beneath Titan's crust, it would be similar to an extremophile bacterium whose metabolism is powered by acetylene. Our second potential group of living organisms contradicts everything we know about biology, which brings us to our first potential group. Titan's hydrocarbon oceans harbor microorganisms that may have evolved on the planet's hostile surface. Such a life form would be incredibly alien compared to anything on Earth. Since it does not require oxygen for survival, it may breathe hydrogen and exhale methane. This barely scratches the surface of what is possible in such extreme conditions. Even for basic cell membranes, it would have to be radically different on Earth. To maintain a cell's viability, membranes filter out substances that would otherwise cause injury and let nutrients in. According to scientists, cell membranes are polar on the outside but nonpolar on the inside. As a corrosive solvent, water is extremely advantageous to the Earth's cells. On the other hand, Titan's legs were composed of nonpolar solvents, so any cells that formed in its frigid depths would have to have membranes that were inverted relative to ours, if they even had membranes. According to a significant research paper published in 2020, membranes would hinder any life in Titan's lakes. Low temperatures would necessitate using small compounds whose diffusion would be slowed by a membrane. The species that evolved in methane seas may not have even possessed cell membranes. A microorganism in this circumstance would inhabit a rock and wait for a wave to travel over the hydrocarbon lake and deliver nutrients. Due to our paucity of astrobiology knowledge, we cannot determine if we have overestimated the likelihood of this organism's existence. Imagining existence on Titan has this effect on the mind. As your mind is contorted and stretched, you are forced to imagine things you have never seen before. At a minimum, we should attempt. The greatest discovery in history would be the discovery of a Titan-based organism that adheres to distinct biological rules. We could simultaneously inhabit multiple locations. If life can persist in such hostile conditions, the universe may be filled with undiscovered species. Titan may conceal extraterrestrial microorganisms, which is excellent news. In a moment, we'll discuss this topic. First, let's examine how we initially learned so much about Titan. The best satellite, Saturn, was first observed by humanity on March 25, 1655. This was a revolutionary period in astronomy. In 1610, a Dutchman named Christian Huygens, a pupil of Galileo, discovered Jupiter's four largest moons. Huygens was preoccupied with discovering Io, Ganymede, Callisto, and Europa, despite being born after Galileo had discovered them. This event also influenced his life. In their early 20s, the two brothers created a telescope to discover something of equal importance. In the spring of 1655, Huygens observed a pinpoint of light orbiting the sixth planet through his telescope. Although additional discoveries would soon eclipse Titan, the discovery of Titan nonetheless sent shockwaves through the astronomical community. 20 years after Huygens realized his scientific ambitions, Giovanni Domenico Cassini discovered four more moons orbiting Saturn. Huygens' creative titling of his discovery necessitated a renaming. After the discovery of Mimas and Solaris by William Herschel, the new system for designating satellite numbers was discarded. All five satellites were assigned four of Saturn's digits. Their numbers will be updated as they are closer to Saturn than the major moons. Saturn had six moons after Titan. As we now know, more than 80 satellites orbit Saturn. The more they were discovered, the clearer it became that Cassini's numbering system had to be revised. Otherwise, astronomers would need clarification forever. John Herschel was responsible for implementing a plan. John Herschel, son of William Herschel, published a treatise in 1847 proposing that naming these moons might be preferable to using numerals. Although its name is interesting, it will be a while before people become enthusiastic about its existence. Technology's limitations played a role in this. A distance greater than 1 billion kilometers from Earth has long been a source of intrigue. Despite discoveries such as Gerard Kuiper's demonstration of methane in Titan's atmosphere in 1907, and Titan's atmosphere being confirmed in 1907, more was required to captivate the public's attention. This has changed with the advent of the first long-range probes. It is astounding to reflect on the space race and comprehend that we went from awestruck by Sputnik 1's brief orbit in 1957 to hurling probes at Saturn. Pioneer 11 was the first spacecraft to visit Titan, taking photographs as it did so 22 years later. The following year, Voyager 1 verified that Titan possessed a thicker atmosphere than Earth. Carl Sagan and others, inspired by Voyager, theorized that extraterrestrial life could exist on this distant planet. Even as early as 1984, NASA and the European Space Agency contemplated the possibility of a joint mission to land a probe on Titan's surface. This mission would later be dubbed Cassini-Huygens. Saturnian discoveries would be worth the delay until the Saturnian system was reached in 2004. Cassini has confirmed the existence of seas on Titan's surface. Cassini maps the surface while peering through Titan's atmosphere with radar and infrared. The Huygens lander was the most remarkable device. On January 14, 2005, during a leisurely parachuting descent onto Titan, Huygens became the first spacecraft to successfully land in the outer solar system. It endured 72 minutes on the frozen ground due to flowing liquids forming local landscape features. What you've seen thus far is nothing compared to what lies ahead. Yes, that is correct. It's time for our favorite segment of the space videos, in which we gaze into the unknown future and attempt to comprehend what's to come. A NASA press officer must have one of the most accessible positions in the world. Why is this so? In contrast to most government departments, you are not required to explain how a tedious task will improve conditions for voters. Instead, you get to discuss things that are so obviously amazing that only a person whose inner child has been surgically removed could appreciate them. It resembles the NASA plan to land a quadcopter on an extraterrestrial moon. The proposal was submitted for the first time in 2000, but was not approved until 2019. Dragonfly is part of the New Frontiers program, which also launched the Pluto probe, so it may be the most thrilling mission we've covered. NASA would deploy a 550-kilogram flying scientific lab on Titan, a drone capable of navigating the frozen terrain and conducting analyses. If you've seen footage of the Martian helicopter's creativity, it's simply to see how this will work. In contrast to Maverick's F-14 and Top Gun, Dragonfly will be significantly more effective than Ingenuity. Because Mars's atmosphere is thinner, Ingenuity was designed to be lightweight. Consequently, mobility is restricted. Its highest altitude was 12 meters, and its longest voyage was 625. As a result, Dragonfly can be significantly larger and more significant, because it operates on a planet with significantly reduced gravity and a much denser atmosphere. We discussed how humans could fly on Titan by attaching wings to their limbs and flapping them effectively instead of flapping their wings earlier. For Dragonfly, an 8-rotor quad design will be used. There is a great deal of lifting required for that. Due to the extreme conditions, the drone can travel 8 kilometers in a single journey. Compared to Opportunity, a Martian rover travels 3 kilometers in roughly 1 year. These are not arbitrary comparisons. Opportunity has traveled farther than any other vehicle on the surface of an alien planet during its tenure. Martian soil has been traversed for 45 kilometers. Over 2.7 years, Dragonfly is anticipated to travel nearly 4 times as far, 175 kilometers. There may be more to follow. Typically, the duration of NASA's rovers exceeds expectations. A 3-month mission extended to 15 years. Since Ingenuity went into effect 30 days ago, it is still operational. If he survives, Dragonfly may be able to traverse an excessive quantity of Titan's terrain. Even if it does not, its ability to reach altitudes of 3.6 kilometers should give us an excellent surface view. What does NASA intend to do with all this high ability? Dragonfly's primary mission is to investigate Titan's lakes and rivers, explore the hydrocarbon dunes, and search for signs of present and former life. Due to the similarity between Titan's atmosphere and Earth's prehistoric atmosphere, it will also search for data that could explain how life evolved on Titan. A scientific accomplishment that delivers a double punch. However, NASA will face obstacles if it is successful. Due to Titan's distance, Dragonfly cannot be commanded in real time, making sorties extremely nerve-wracking. Moreover, timescales play a role. Dragonfly, scheduled to launch in 2027, will not reach Saturn's largest moon until 2036. In the event of a malfunction, a replacement will not arrive until we are all very elderly. Dragonfly is not the only proposed Titan mission, however. Although it is the only one to receive approval, other equally intriguing candidates exist. In 2047, for instance, an orbiter-submarine combination could be sent to Titan's legs. This submarine could travel 3,000 kilometers in 90 days, exploring the interiors of Crake and Mars to uncover their secrets. There are also high hopes that NASA's policy will include a second planned visit to Titan in proposals for the 2024 round of New Horizons funding. If that fails, a boat could be placed on the ocean's surface to take readings and investigate this remote ocean. Fans of this strange alien world, this inverse Earth akin to ours but so hostile to life, live in an exciting time. Today's video will conclude with a glimmer of hope for the future, where we may soon uncover fascinating things about Saturn's fascinating satellite. Things that Christian Huygens could only dream about on March 24, 1655, when he peered through his telescope at the night sky.